if you don't wear mask, you can get punishment 10 juta rupiah.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh guys. Kembali lagi bersama aku di channel Bung Tanjung. Dan kali ini aku hanya ingin bacot doang. Jadi kalau kalian mau dengar bacotanku tentang perbedaan negara Eropa dan negara Indonesia, especially Pontianak, dan untuk menangani virus corona atau COVID-19. Dan kemarin itu aku ada lihat di teman-teman share di grup, itu sekitar yang terinfeksi yang masih di dalam pengawasan itu 500-an lebih orang, dan nanti aku akan tampilin fotonya di sini. Dan banyak yang mengeluhkan kepada pemerintah yang ada di Pontianak untuk apa ya, just stay at home. Jadi banyak juga yang aku lihat di Facebook itu banyak yang komentarnya agak kasar. Jadi mereka bilangnya begini, kalau stay di rumah, siapa yang mau biayain keluarganya? Jadi biaya keluarganya kan, contohnya aja orang yang itu orang yang kerja buruh harian itu kan dapatnya uangnya per hari. Jadi kalau mereka nggak kerja, jadi pemasukan nggak ada. Bagaimana untuk mendapatkan masukan untuk memberi nafkah kepada keluarga mereka? Jadi aku nggak tahu gimana ya, nggak, no comment lah kalau ini aku salah omong. Jadi pun kalau aku pribadi juga kerja di sebuah perusahaan, dan ya sampai sekarang masih kerja, nggak ada hitungan libur atau gimana, nggak ada. Jadi hanya ada himbauan dari manajemen bahwa jaga kesehatan, makan makanan yang bergizi, dan cuci tangan, masker, dan sebagainya, yang kalian tahu sendirilah. Dan aku akan compare kepada gimana pemerintahan di Eropa sama di pemerintahan di Indonesia menangani COVID-19 ini. Jadi aku akan telepon dia, bule, ya, cewek, cakep. Nanti aku akan tunjukin fotonya. Jadi nanti aku akan, dan ini kan ngomongnya pakai bahasa Inggris ya, mungkin aku akan translatein ataupun aku akan edit, soalnya aku cuman edit pakai HP doang, jadi agak kurang mumpuni. Jadi semua videoku itu semuanya pakai HP doang editnya. Dan ya mungkin aku akan coba translatein, dan aku akan telepon dia sekarang, dan aku akan speaker. Jadi kalau ada bahasa Inggris yang salah, tolong dimaklumi dan dikoreksi.
Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam. Ya. Iniska. I want to asking you about how government from Europe, especially Czech Republic, they care about COVID-19.
Yeah, sure. So till now we have 904 cases with COVID, and 6 people are in a critical condition. Mm-hmm. 4 people are already healthy. And in my region, we have 46 people which are infected. And in my city, we have 2 people with COVID. But it's also curious because everyone has different symptoms.
So you are stuck, right? At home?
Yeah, we have status daurat for 1 month now. We can't go outside normally. We can go outside just if you go to doctor, if you go shop some food, or if you go to pharmacy, or if you need to go to office, or you can also go for a walk to Bhutan or somewhere, but just for a while. So we have new measures here that you have to wear mask. If you don't wear mask, you can get punishment 10 juta rupiah.
Jadi kalau di sana, kalau kalian nggak, dia bilang kalau nggak pakai masker, jadi kalian itu didenda 10 juta. Di Indonesia, men, kalian lihat sendiri, masker aja harganya gila-gilaan. Orang jual, ya kalian tahu sendirilah, kalian lihat di online shop, kalian lihat di online shop itu harganya gila-gilaan. Jadi aku nggak tahu di sini masih ada apa nggak jual, tapi aku pribadi nggak pakai masker. Pakai sih, tapi dari perusahaan. Jadi kalau di Eropa itu, di Ceko, kalau kalian nggak pakai masker, kalian didenda 10 juta oleh pemerintah. What else?
Yeah, and next again, we don't have any mask here in apothek or in shop or in online. We don't have any mask.
I see.
So we have to make our mask at home. We have to make homemade masks. Creating masks from t-shirts or from some cotton. Yeah, so we have to make homemade masks.
And then, what is the benefit? What is again, what is the government do about this COVID-19? About healthy, about doctor?
Yes, sure. We have in front of every hospital here, we have tent, and you can test if you have COVID or not. It's for before it was for some. Free, but now it's free. So if you feel that you have symptoms of COVID, you can go there and they will test you. And I think till next day you will know it.
But before you have to pay it, right? But now already free.
Yes.
Ya, jadi sebelumnya itu dibayar. Kalian harus bayar, tapi sekarang itu udah free. Jadi kalau kalian mau tes, ya tes aja datang. Dan itu free, nggak tahu di Pontianak free apa nggak. Kalau ada yang tahu free atau nggak, komen di bawah. Bayar atau nggak, komen di bawah, oke? Okay? But you say to me, when you don't feel good, doctor can go to your house.
Yes, sure. If you come from Italy, so many people which went to Italy for skiing or for holiday, so many people got it in Italy and then now they are in quarantine at home. So if you call for call center, if you call for call center here, you will say, I came from Italy, I don't know, 1 week ago and I don't feel well, I'm scared that I have COVID. So they will come to you and they will take that test for COVID at home, because our government decided it isn't good if you would go to doctor, and also now doctors are closed here. If you have flu or if you have some problem, you have to call for a doctor and he will talk with you through phone, and if it won't help, so you can go to hospital.
So jadi dia bilang banyak orang yang pergi skiing dan waktu sebulan yang lalu itu kan salju. Jadi orang-orang itu pergi ke sana ke Italia untuk skiing. Jadi kalau seandainya kalian pulang ke negara kalian, maksudnya ke Ceko, jadi kalian merasa nggak enak badan, jadi kalian telepon emergency, nanti itu dokternya akan datang ke kalian ataupun telepon ke kalian gitu. Jadi kalian nggak harus keluar karena itu sangat tidak worth it untuk keluar. Jadi mungkin kalian terkena infect dari corona, jadi lebih baik di rumah dan tidak menyebarkan virus itu ke orang-orang lain. Okay, so what is the benefit when you can stay at home? About when people go to work, right? People go to work, they earn money, go to work, and then people there cannot go to work, right? So they got full salary, right?
Yes, sure. If you can go work, if your boss can't pay you job because of this COVID, so he will pay you for 100% salary, like if you would go to work. Because this is problem because of COVID and because boss can't give you work, so he has to pay you full salary.
Oh, nice. Jadi buat pemerintahan di Indonesia, nggak tahu di pabrik atau di mana atau di instansi manapun ya. Jadi di Eropa itu, jadi kalau kalian itu kerja dan dalam keadaan genting kayak gini, jadi kalian itu dapat full gaji. Jadi nggak ada potongan sama sekali. Ya seperti aku, nggak ada libur, nggak dikasih libur, jadi ya harus kerja. Nggak kerja nggak dapat uang, coy. Jadi ya harus kerja. And then you say to me you got free wifi, right? 1 month.
Jadi, yeah, sure. I got wifi free, and then we got also some special TV programs for free.
Yeah. So jadi
yeah, because
jadi di sana itu dia di Ceko itu dia dapat free wifi 1 bulan. Jadi dan untuk channel TV jadi mereka enggak perlu bayar sebulan. Ya lumayan, di sini Indonesia enggak dapat apa-apa, cuy. Enggak dapat apa-apa. Jadi pemerintah bilang ya knockdown, enggak bisa keluar mana-mana, tapi pemerintah enggak ada ngasih benefit gitu. Ya tapi kesadaran diri masing-masing juga sih untuk tidak menyebarkan virus ini. Ya semoga aja sebelum Ramadan virus ini berakhir di Indonesia, di Pontianak. Amin amin amin. Okay, so that's it already. I mean, has a lot again. Do you have again more benefit from this COVID from government from Europe?
Yeah, maybe we will have more because we don't know which situation will be in 1 week or in 2 weeks. Because I know that in Italy people don't have to pay electric, people don't have to pay some water, people don't have to pay.
Oh yeah, it's all free, right? House.
They have it for free.
That's nice.
Yes. Jadi because in Italy it's really
worse. Jadi di Italia itu katanya di sana semuanya free, air, listrik segala macam free. Jadi ini kan keadaan genting, jadi semuanya dikasih free sama pemerintah di sana. Karena di Italia yang kalian tahu sendiri itu lebih parah COVID-19-nya. Banyak yang meninggal. Has a lot of people die there, right?
Yeah, I think yesterday it was the most. Yesterday it was
400.
600.
Yeah, 600. Yeah. 640 men yang meninggal day, di Italia. Mampus.
Yeah, because they didn't care at first about COVID. They 3 weeks they already know that they had COVID, but they didn't make any rules. Any measures. And then it's so worse.
Yeah.
But also in Spain it's also similar. Spain are also so many cases, and in France and Germany it's also similar, but in France and Germany it's a bit better.
Yeah, it's good.
But yeah, these countries are I think the most infected in Europe.
Yeah. I don't know, maybe there is so cold, maybe. So that's all.
Yeah, and also I forgot, we have closed school till 18 April. But today I read that our government wants to decide that maybe people will go to school in September.
What the heck? That's all okay, right?
Yeah, I think so. I don't know if people want to know about symptoms. Here, it's so different. Every person has different symptoms.
I don't know about that.
Because in my city, 2 people have it. And then they have other symptoms. One person didn't have batuk. He had just sore throat, and then he had headache. And I think in Indo, especially in Indo, because it's so crowded, people shouldn't go to doctor if they don't have some high fever, or if they don't have problem with breathing, they should stay at home and they should just try to heal it at home, because if everyone will go to doctor, they will infect so many people. And
yeah, I know.
Yeah, it will be so hard.
So yeah, okay, that's all. I just want to know about that. So, jadi di sana itu katanya nanti akan close penerbangan segala macam itu sampai tanggal 18 katanya. 18 April, dan katanya anak-anak sekolah itu mau diliburkan sampai September. Aduh, parah men, parah. Enggak tahu nanti Indonesia di Pontianak especially macam mana ya. Jadi tadi dibilang banyak orang yang terinfeksi, dan ya banyak juga benefit-benefitnya dari listrik, dari wifi juga segala macam, dan tentang dokternya juga. Jadi apa lagi ya? Oh iya, tadi dia bilang kalau yang terkena corona itu, kalau di sana itu berbeda-beda. Jadi ada yang merasakan batuk, cuman batuk, ada yang merasakan pusing kepala. Jadi itu sangat sulit diindikasi. Jadi kalau kalian ya untuk jaga-jaga diri ya di rumah lebih baik. Oke. Jadi aku pikir ya semoga Indonesia dan seluruh dunia COVID ini sudah akan berakhir. Aku nggak mau, kita juga nggak mau ya sebagai umat Muslim merayakan Ramadan itu dengan virus yang begini, nggak seru men. Jadi ya kita berdoa bersama, kita dukung cara pemerintah untuk menangani COVID-19 ini di Pontianak. Ya semoga kita dalam lindungan, tetap jaga kesehatan untuk kalian semua. Dan jika ada pertanyaan, jika ada yang kurang jelas, tolong komen di bawah dan aku akan jawab pastinya. Dan jangan lupa like video ini jika kalian suka, mungkin kepanjangan. Dan ya, okay, that's all. Thanks for watching guys, dan assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, dan peace.